Welcome to the class of editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding Indian historiography under threat, written by Harbans Mukhiya. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 1. Plus this is very important for history optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about how there is a need to write history apolitically in an unbiased manner, and how there is a need not to color the history solely from the perspective of religion. This editorial is also about how the current dispensation is trying to maneuver the history for their own benefit. Now, in order to understand this editorial, first of all, we need to know about the importance of history as a subject. Now, history is not just a subject. History is an approach to learn about how the human civilization has progressed, how the human civilization has fought with the environmental forces, how the human civilization has fought with the social evils, how the human civilization has come out with the ideas of democracy, human rights and welfare. Human civilization is also about how the future progression might be taking place. So the history is a very big guide. History is just like a philosophy of how the future should be lived, of how the present should be lived. History is like a friend. So this is the essence of history as a subject. From history we can learn about the mistakes. From history we can learn about the lessons. History is nothing but a vision to the future. So it is very important that this subject should be written apolitically. Whatever was the reality should be presented. History should not be presented in an unbiased manner. But the biggest irony for the mankind is that the history has never been written apolitically. There is a biasness, even unintended biasness, which actually goes into the writings of the history. But what is the problem with the history as far as the India as a subcontinent is concerned? History in the subcontinent, it was written in a standard form by the British historians. And these British historians, the colonial historians, they have actually presented a wrong image about the Indian history. They have emphasized more on the religious aspect. And it was because of all this, till date, we have been viewing the history from like the ancient phase as the Hindu phase of the Indian history, the medieval phase as the Muslim phase of the Indian history, and the current phase as the colonial phase of the Indian history. So coloring the entire history just on the basis of religion is not right, because you can never generalize a period. The human development, the human progression, it has taken place and developed in two dimensions. One dimension is the dimension of time, the another dimension is the dimension of space. It's the space multiplying with the time has created this human civilization. So it is the duty of a historian to come out with the right facts, to come out with the right analysis, to come out with the right bearings. Because only then we will be able to get the right idea about how the society has progressed. Now the current dispensation, what they are trying to do? They are trying to unearth the history in order to create their own iconography. Now, what is this iconography and how they are trying to unearth the history? Bharatiya Janata Party's main aim is Hindi, Hindu and Hindutva. And because of that, they want a kind of a support system which could strengthen themselves, which could provide a kind of a moral, a psychological and cultural support. And for this support, they are trying to dig the history from their own perspective. So attempts are being made to rewrite the history in which the ancient face is being more glossed over. Recently at a conference that was organized by the historians, a fact is being presented that the Vedic and later Vedic phase, it was more older than the Harappan culture. Now why this attempt is being made? This attempt is being made in order to give a more sanctified, a more sacramental, a more creditable status to the Hindu religion. So an attempt to rewrite the history and projecting the wrong information is something that is not right for the human civilization. History is being used as a weapon to garner the profits in the elections. In the same manner, BJP is again trying to create their own cadre of nationalists which they believed were associated with the BJP ideology which currently they are pursuing. So they are digging the history to look out for the people who had the rightist ideology, and these people who were capable enough to counter the ideology of the Gandhi, to counter the ideology of the Jawaharlal Nehru. And in this attempt, they have succeeded to align themselves with Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, and now attempts are being made by the BJP to project Subhash Chandra Bose as the leader of their ideology. And then they believe in the another iconographic figures like Madan Mohan Malviya and Deen Dayal Upadhyay. So this kind of attempt is not right. So you must read this editorial from this perspective that I have told you. So then you will be able to get the true idea of this editorial. So this was all for this editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 845-940-000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.